Did you know you can write something that looks like this? It looks kind of like a random string of characters. Hit tab on your keyboard and there's a whole bunch of CSS that just shows up there. That's Emmet for CSS, and it's what we're going to be looking at in this video. A lot of people know about Emmet with HTML. I've already done a video on it. If you haven't seen that one, go and check it out. It is linked in the description below, but that's what most people are familiar with. They don't even realize that Emmet also works with CSS, and I wanted to show you what it's all about. So let's go and take a look right here. I am in VS Code for this, but which Emmet comes pre-installed with VS Code. If you're using another one, another editor, you might have to get an extension or something like that to get it working there. All right, so let's start with the magic here. And the first thing, let's just say, you know, a lot of time you'll select your body and on here you want a few things like a margin of zero. So instead of coming and writing margin zero, I mean, that takes a lot of keystrokes, right? Maybe not too many, but it's not too bad. But what we can do is M0 and hit tab and look at that, margin zero. So that's really cool, really handy. And just to show you, it is like, say we do an M0 again, it's when I push tab on the keyboard that it auto completes. So that was me pushing tab. But also if I do an M0, not M9, M0, and I push enter or return, it gives me the same result. So whether you're using enter or tab, I have a tendency to use tab just because it's what I'm used to when I write Emmet in HTML, but either one is completely fine. So let's say, let's leave our body like that with a margin of zero, but let's come and say we have, we have a container in here, right? So a container or a wrapper. And on that, we want to add a few different things. So there's a few different ways, but sometimes you'll put some padding on here. So let's say we want padding, but we want to use M or rem on the side. So you can go 2R, and if I do padding 2R and hit tab, then I have my padding of 2rem. So padding of 2rem, nice and easy on that. And then you can come and say we could give it a width, and maybe we want just to make sure the width is always 100%. So we could do 100p for percent, and there you go. And that's nice and easy because you don't have to go and find the percent key. So again, that's just width 100p and hit tab, and you get your width 100% if ever you need something like that. But a lot of the time, you know, you don't need to really do that on your container. We'll leave it there for now. But you might want a max width as well to prevent it from getting too big. That's usually the point of the container. So for a max width, you do MA, and it's not MAX because max, you know, then it's just MA. And then what do we want? I don't know, let's say 75 rem. So again, it's just the letter R, hit tab, and we have a max width on there. And we want a margin of auto now, right? Or zero auto. So then we can do an M for margin, zero. And if ever you have multiple values or you want more than one, you just need a hyphen. It took me a second there to find it, but we just need to put a hyphen and then the value that you want. So let's just start with 10 and hit tab, and it gives me 10 pixels. We don't want 10 pixels though. So let's say we did 10E. Well, that would give me 10M, not what we're after. But we could do an auto right here as well and hit tab, and then it's our margin zero auto. So that's pretty cool. But that did take me a little bit of time. Now, a little bit longer because I was saying it out loud, but we could speed all of that up. So we saw myself doing that. So what we could do for the exact same thing is a P2R for my padding 2R, and then we can combine different property value pairs together by putting a plus. So I could do width 100P plus an MA of 75R plus a M of zero hyphen auto and hit tab, and it gives me all four of them at the same time. Ah, so cool, so handy, and really, really nice. So that's one way you could speed up your workflow a little bit there, right? A little bit like when you're using Emmet with HTML. I'm already falling in love with this a little bit. And so we could do a little bit more. There's other properties as well. And because CSS does have so many potential properties, some of them do get a little weird. So font size, you would think would be FS, but that doesn't. That's FS is for font style. So font size is with a Z. So that does take a little bit getting used to. Maybe you do a 1R and you get that. Now, also just quickly on this FZ, if you do 1rem, it's still going to work. So if you write out the whole unit, it's completely fine. You won't muck it, which is really nice because I'm so used to hitting rem. Now that I've been playing with this, I do find sometimes I put out the full unit anyway. So, and this is the same. So font size, if I said that the font size was 1M, I could do either just an E and get it or a font. Oh, I got a font style there. See, there it is with the S, but font size of 1M, and I could do it and get the font size of 1M as well. And again, it does take a little bit of getting used to, obviously, to find the ones that you want to find. So as a quick other example is maybe you have something like a card, and on our card, we want to do a little bit of magic with this. Now, for some reason, maybe this card has a smaller font size than normal. So we could, on this whole card, say the font size is like a 0.925R, plus. We want some padding on that. So maybe it's a padding of 2m plus we want a margin. I don't know why, but let's just say that it has a bit of margin on there. So we have a margin of 1m. And then we say we want a background color and text color as well. So you can do that here too. And there are a few things with this, and there's a little bit more that you can do with it. But background colors is, you can do BG for background or BGC for background color. And we can add on, so we have background color plus we want just a color, so that's a nice C. Let's say we want flex, so display flex. Now I also want to change the flex direction, so I can do an FXD and hit tab on that. And look at that, we get all of these things coming through. And you'll notice that my cursor has been auto placed in a few spots. So if I come and I backspace, I can get rid of those and I can come in. So here my background color, I actually want this to be, let's say black, we don't need that. This is white. And then we can come in and change my flex direction. So that speeds things up a little bit right there, obviously. But we can actually up our game a little bit with this. So I'm just gonna control Z to get to here. So what you can do is when you have a background color or a color, you can also put a colon and actually define stuff. So here I'm just gonna write red. And then over here where we have the C, I'm gonna write black. And then if ever you have this, just like add to it a little bit, like go back and then forward again. If ever you have a make a change, just to make sure it picks up the whole thing, hit tab. And look at that, it put my red and my black. And the flex direction, because I left it blank actually this time, it put a row on there. But why don't we, let's do the whole thing again just to really show you the power of this. So font size with AZ of, we said 0.925R, and you can see I put a colon there by accident. It's still going to work fine, so there's no problem. So font size 9.25 rem plus a padding of 2m plus a margin of 1 rem, let's do, instead of m that we did last time. Plus we want a color of red. Plus we want a background of, this is gonna be really ugly, but a BG of, this would be really ugly, but background of black. Don't actually use these values for something. Plus we want a flex, display flex. So plus display flex. Plus we want a flex direction with FXD, because XFD is something else, because there's probably font display or something. And on this, I'm going to put a C and hit tab, and oh my goodness, isn't that just so cool and so wonderful? So I'd like to know, do you already use Emmet for CSS, or maybe you haven't been using it, but now that you've seen it in action, you would like to start using it? In either case, leave a comment down below and let me know what the situation on that is. A really big thank you for watching. An extra big thank you to Zach, who is my enabler of awesome, as well as all my other patrons for their support each and every month. And of course, until next time, don't forget to make your corner of the internet just a little bit more awesome.